Pool planning software that field teams actually use. I love this topic. I'm going to talk to you right now about some of the key things that we have to remember, and I'm going to answer five specific questions that have been sent our way in relation to this topic. And I couldn't be more excited, so stay with us. So right now there's a book called Takt Planning, which we'll link you to in the description below, and Takt Steering and Control. You're going to want to check those out. They're absolutely amazing. Another video that we'll link you to is called A Real Pool Plan. So I hosted the meeting. All the trade partners were new to pool planning. They were not prepared, and it was online, and I recorded it. That will be in the description below. But here's the problem. If you do pool planning the way the industry teaches, it will overrun the deadline most of the time. You will have large batch areas that do not serve your overall throughput time for the phase and your overall schedule, and it will not have flow. And here's the reason why. Because people will say a couple things. I'm just gonna dispel all the myths. One of the myths about pool planning is that you have to have physical stickies. Well, people can interact with it. I understand that. They need to be interacting with the information. It doesn't matter if they touch a sticky. It doesn't matter if they write it by hand. Here's the problem with doing it with real stickies by hand. And I know I've lost you already. You're mad at me. But I promise if you stay, you'll see the wisdom in this. Their handwriting is horrible. And nobody can see, literally nobody, what all the stickies mean. And so you've got it up on the wall and it looks like a mess. And all this was an activity to get the person to write it and put it on the wall. Nothing else happens really. I always, even if I'm in person, do a pull plan online. Always, always, always. I will never, unless I'm asked, do a pull plan with real sticky notes. I won't do it because I want on my big screen TV, and I haven't seen a job site without a big screen TV or a projector. I want them to see the digital whiteboard. I want them to see the stickies in beautiful, clear, typed lettering so that they can see what they need to see and we can do a quick analysis and I can get remote support. The other thing is somebody will say, but Jason, only that trade partner can declare that or can touch that sticky. No, it's not touch the sticky, it's declare the sticky. So if you're using a big whiteboard, only that trade partner can declare the item, the duration, and the placement. So if I'm moving it around for them and it ends up where they've declared it to be and how long it needs to be, that's super fine. The other thing that's a horrible myth in the industry is that you pull plan these areas. Like I'm gonna go pull plan the floor, or I'm gonna go pull plan that whole phase, or I'm gonna go pull plan this massive area. No, you don't. You pull plan a single zone in a phase, a small area in a phase. So if you're doing the interiors, you do one zone. You should be pool planning 5,000 to 15,000 square feet of area, nothing more. And then what you do is you put together that pool plan and you can go forward and back or back and forward and you create that nice sequence. And when you go forward, that takes care of the job. When you go back, you get all preceding tasks and needs taken care of and you take care of the trade. So you have both persons' needs met. So what you wanna do is do it by zone and you have to use the Takt time or the Takt calculator rather, to calculate your zone sizes. So that means you should never do a single pull plan unless you have a single zone. If you have multiple zones throughout the phase, that pull plan gets compared on top of other pull plans to make sure that they flow diagonally and to make sure that we hit the end milestone. So that means that we have to go into a certain format. And I remember when I first started learning pull planning that they were like, you can put a 5-day activity into one sticky. And some people were like, no, if you have a 5-day activity, create 5 stickies. And if you're doing that in person, nobody wants to create 5 stickies. The literal answer here is, and my preferred software is to do it on Miro and to have the stickies inside the format to show the start and the end milestone. Do the stickies, your forward and backward pass, then compare the other phases, look for a diagonal trade flow. It's real easy to have a sticky per day and you're jamming, ready to go. Everybody can read it. Everybody declared it. You're still following the same rules and you've accelerated farther forward from your end milestone for the phase. So that is genius. Now, if you're like, Jay Money, I have no idea what you're talking about, go to the description below, please. That's a call to action, actually. And please go see how I did it. I think you'll be very, very impressed, and it's all right there. You'll see what I'm talking about. So now let me answer some questions. So the first question, what is the best pull planning software on the market? I'm gonna get myself in trouble. I know of a lot of them. I'll just mention a couple. There's one that starts with H, there's one that starts with N, and there's one that starts with T, and there's actually a bunch of others. I don't like them. It forces everybody, to all the trade partners, to get on another app, to create their own stickies, and to do all of the work that distracts them so that they're actually not looking at what they need to be looking at, and it forces you into their graphical user interface, and it forces you to do the remainder of your planning the wrong way, meaning typically using CPM in the wrong type of last planner format, and it's not useful when you export to other systems, and I will include CPM in this, and it's not useful for your field format. And one of the biggest considerations is like, you're like, how much will this cost on this project per year? They're like 75 grand. You're like, oh my gosh, like literally for 75 grand, I could literally pay Lean Takt, us, to literally do the planning with the supers, train the entire staff, manage it every week, do it on their application on Intact, and like literally print everything out and help us every step of the way with visuals and a whole lot more for the same costs. Like, I'm not paying $75,000 for one software that we barely use. And so people are like, well, Jason, there's a lot you have to do in Miro. I have the template. In fact, in this file, I'm gonna give you five links to emails that you can send, pull plan templates that you can send, the Miro board that you can use as a template, the whole thing. I would use Miro. It's so easy to go up and to do your pull plan and then copy it down and analyze. It's so collaborative. And if you want everybody to hop in and do their own stickies, they still can. It has every function that you would need. And then you can take it and put it where it needs to be. And you can actually grab those stickies and have it translate into other formats as well. Miro is quite fantastic. Now, some people like Felipe Engineer use Miro. Totally fine. I love Mural too. Great, great application. Question two, why doesn't my team use what we've already paid for? Well, the answer is like, oh, let me give you an example here. And this is the hard truth. Most construction softwares nowadays don't actually work. Like the legacy applications like Bluebeam, AutoCAD, Revit, Excel, even though some people don't like it. I mean, Excel can have formula bus and an estimate, but everything else is great for. These programs worked like so well in construction for so many years. You know, like Navisworks, even Synchro, Google SketchUp, you know, these are like great programs. But nowadays, because there isn't a solid base on lean construction planning, 99% of the applications are going in the wrong direction. They're like, we'll do last planner system with CPM, wrong. We'll do last planner with CPM, wrong. We'll do a new version of CPM, wrong. We'll do last planner with large blatch areas, wrong. We're just gonna do pull planning, wrong. Wrong, 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 and some more wrong. These are wrong. And so the dumbest thing anybody can do, and yes, I know you're mad at me now, is to mandate a certain type of software for everybody to use. There's a healthcare client that mandates, I'm not gonna say the name, but it starts with a V, a certain last planner application, and it slows everything down, and everybody is hobbled by it. It's literally like you handcuffed everybody. It's never lean to mandate software. Software should speak for itself. People aren't using it because it's garbage, and it doesn't matter that you bought it on an enterprise agreement or that you mandated it. You need to use thoroughly tested software, just like it says in the 14 principles of the Toyota way. How can we still use sticky notes and go digital? Miro, sticky notes, digital, you're set. What's the difference between a pull plan and a Gantt chart? Well, a Gantt chart is simply the little bar durations on the Gantt chart listed out on separate line items in time, organized typically by deliverable, not by location. So a pull plan should be organized by location, and a pull plan has your forward pass of commitments and your backwards pass of needs, and it really respects trade partners, but a Gantt chart is just another push system on par with CPM, and it's not effective. How do you keep your digital plan alive past the meeting or your pull plan alive past the pull plan? Here's the answer. All pull plans become norm level TAC plans. That's it. All a pull plan is a single sequence in a zone for a TAC plan. And all a TAC plan is multiple pull plans in multiple zones for the phase. That's it. And that's what people are missing. A pull plan, unless it's one zone, is never shown on one line. It's always shown as a cascade. And so I invite you to check out the information in the description below. And here's a call to action. We at Lean Takt can help you. If you want help running this pull plan, we can help you. We will hop on. We got you covered. So reach out to us. Give us a call. On we go.